So let's say in Active Directory is generally called as a multi master architecture. Multi master architecture means every domain controller is same as per capability. Okay, so it means that you can create a user group computer in every domain controller in a domain, correct? So like that, in a traditional architecture you have something which is called as an master and a slave. Okay, so in a master and a slave model, your master can only write the data and the slave can only read the data. Okay, for an example, your DNS is a master slave architecture where the data is get updated only on a master and slave is a read only copy. You cannot change the data, you cannot update the data. But in an Active Directory, all the domain controller are all exact equal. There is no difference. Are you working on a domain controller 1? Are you working on a domain controller 2? Are you working on a domain controller 3? So it says that in all scenarios, all domain controller are same. It means that you can create a user here also. You can create a user here also. So for example, in any company, when you have a same kind of a capability exist in a team, generally to control the team, you make one as a team leader. Okay. So team leader is also a person who is among that engineers. Correct. So let's say in a team, you have a 10 engineer. You say that one person will manage the roster, correct? Another person will manage the leaves. So this is the way you divide the responsibility. But when you talked about the core functionality, all are same. All is doing the same job. Okay. Some has the additional responsibility. So just like that, same way in Active Directory also, since all domain controller are equal, few domain controller can have an additional responsibility. Okay, so in a multi-master replication model, in multi-master architecture, few server can be designated as or you can say that few server can be given an or assigned as an additional responsibility. Assigned to perform some additional task. Okay, so the domain controller which perform the specific task is called as an operation master. So in this scenario, a DC which perform additional task is known as operation master. Okay, now let's understand that what all the role which can be performed in a domain. So very first role which is called as an, we called it as an FSMO role, flexible single master operation. Single master operation. One of the very important architecture is say that this FSMO role can be divided in a two part, one which domain specific. In a domain specific, each domain must have one server which can be designated as a PDC operation master role. in a domain, at least one server which should be designated as infrastructure master role. And in a domain, one server must be designated as RID master role. So these are the three specific role which is defined in a domain. Each domain. Same way, in a complete forest where you have a multi-domain architecture and you have a lot of child domain and all, in a forest, at least one domain controller of any domain must be designated as an schema master role. And one domain controller should be designate as domain naming master role. Okay, so if I go back to my old architecture, let's say for an example, in this scenario, I will make this domain as an, this DC as an PDC. This can be act as an RID. This domain controller can be act as an, the third one can be act as an infrastructure. Likewise that in the another domain, one domain controller is designated as PDC. One domain controller can be designated as infrastructure. And another domain controller can be designated as RID. In a scenario where USA has only one domain controller, the single domain controller perform all the role means it is RID plus PDC plus the infrastructure. So all role will be played by a single domain controller, just like your scenario. In another case, I have designated RID plus infrastructure on one server and I will make PDC as a one server. So it means that this PDC, RID and infrastructure is a domain specific role. Each domain, at least one domain controller must be designated to perform this role. Okay, and then in a whole forest, one server can be designated as a schema operation master. So for an example, this server which is belongs to a TechPledge domain is also act as an schema operation master role. And this server in India domain, I have designated them as an domain naming master. So the forest role is only designated to one DC in a whole forest, while the domain one will be designated to each domain at least one controller. So the PDC master role has a very first responsibility . Now generally what happened that, let's say for an example, user has changed the password here. User changed the password on this domain controller. Okay, user password get changed on this domain controller because this domain controller belongs to a Chennai and user currently in a Chennai. So in a Chennai, he changed the password. The moment he changed the password, his change will first updated on the local domain controller. Then your local domain controller will check that what is the replication interval I have to replicate the changes to the another domain controller. So let's say for an example, I say that any changes which is updated on a domain controller will replicate it to 15 minutes. So it means that this change will come to this domain controller in a 15 minute, okay? And from here, again I say that the interval between to come the changes from here to here is another 15 minutes. And same way, the changes to come here from here to here is another 15 minutes. Now, in this scenario, let's say for an example, user change the password and which is updated on this domain controller. Now, user take the remote of any application which is available on this domain controller. Okay, this particular domain controller. So, when the user try to access that application which is available on this domain controller, the username and password will try to validate in this domain controller itself. So this domain controller will check its data and say that the password is incorrect. Why so? Because the password is still not replicated here. User has changed the password, and within 30 minutes the user try to access the application which is get authenticated locally on this domain controller itself. So it said that password is incorrect and it does not let the user logged in. User will say that, yaar, I have just changed the password. But this domain controller say that I have no information about your password change. Okay. So it reject the login request. What it does? It reject the login request. Correct. So this is a very typical scenario when you are working on a multi-domain controller you have, and you have this, it is in different sites and the replication is scheduled, right? So if you have a PTC operation master, what is its role is that the moment the password gets changed, regardless of the schedule, your domain controller will first update the changes to the PDC. So the password changes, which changes on any DC, will first update on PDC. So what is the advantage it get when it update on a PDC? Any domain controller when they receive the login request with new password, it first check with PDC before rejecting the login. Okay, so in this case, this domain controller will ask the PDC, dear PDC, a user is claiming that they have a new password. Do you have any information? The PDC says that yes, the user, the password has been changed for the user. Here is a new password. He said that thank you very much. This is what the user is requesting for. It means that user is right. And it let the user to log in on that application. Now, in this scenario, if your, let's say for an example, if the PDC operation master is down, what will happen? So, if the PDC operation master is down, the password change will take very long time, because the moment you try to change your password on your laptop, your request will go to the domain controller, local domain controller, first try to contact the PDC and the PDC is down, then it will try contacting your PDC. So sometimes when the PDC is down, if you change the password, it will say, it will sometime take 15 minutes even. Now let's understand RID master, which is called relative identifier. Remember, okay, so once again, so RID master, what this role is saying, that it assigned the pool of RID to every domain controller in domain. What is this RID? Is that RID is basically a relative identifier which is assigned to every object in a domain when it was created. So this particular ID is constitute of an entity identifier, then domain identifier, and then the SID, which is called a security identifier. Okay, so now let's understand, go back to your domain controller, go to regedit, start run, type regedit. In a search box, type regedit, R-E-G-E-D-I-T. Click that. No, it's not MSC. Okay. Now go to H key current user or H key user. Expand that. Go to H key user. Now you are able to see that there is something called S-1-5-18. Right? So this particular ID is called as an NT ID. Any NT identifier or Windows identifier is always a start with the word called S-X-Y-Z. Okay, so wherever in the world when you see this, you please understand that this particular ID is belongs to a Windows. This is a proprietary to a Windows. Okay, now can you just stretch it? Stretch it. No, stretch that. Stretch it. Stretch it till last. Yes. Hold on. Now after that, if you see that it's below, it is showing that there is something which is called as an S-1-5-21, which is again it's a NT, and then there is a three unique digit, then the last one is a 500. So this three unique digit is called as a domain ID. Every user or group or a computer, when you create in an Active Directory, it got this three ID common. This is telling that this particular ID belongs to a domain. And your domain ID, what is your domain ID? Your domain ID is this one, 271317505-3471. So this three octet is your domain ID. And what is the 500? 500 is called a relative identifier, right? It is called the RID. So your domain ID plus RID is, you can say, make it something which is called as an SID, a security identifier for an object. Okay, so this is a security identifier for an object. So each object which you create in an Active Directory is always has this identifier. So this 500 is very important. Now let's come back to the PPT.
Yes. So it means that when you, let's say for an example, you have a DC one. Let's say you have a DC one, okay? Your DC one has been assigned an RID pool, which is say that 1000 to 2000. So it means that when any user is created in DC one, it got an RID which start from 1000. Next user when you create, it create another one which is called a 1001. Next user when you create, it will create another one which is a 1002. Till when? Till 2000. What will happen when this 2000 is over? Then your domain controller will contact the RID. Then RID might assign another RID pool to them. So if I have another DC, I have another DC which is a DC2. Definitely it will get an RID pool which is a start from 2001 to a 3001. Correct? So what is the role of the RID master? RID master is assign the RID pool to each domain controller so that the domain controller should assign the unique SID always to the user. There should not be any duplicate. Okay. So if the RID master is not available, what will happen? If RID master is down, no impact on the domain until every domain controller adjusted with their IDs. Till the time the RID is available to every domain controller, it does not require the RID master. Okay, because the RID master always allocate the relative identifier to every domain controller when the domain controller starts or when the domain controller created, and that is a 65,000 RID has been assigned to each domain controller.
It's a default.
So it means that if someone asks you that how many user you can create in a domain, so what is the virtual limit on a domain controller? It's a 65,000. After that, it go and contact the RID master and it will ask for a new RID. Okay. Now come to the next one, which is called the infrastructure master. So let's come to the infrastructure master and we are going to copy the group one. Where is the group? Okay. So let me copy it. Now understand the infrastructure master very clearly. The role of the infrastructure master role is it maintain the group and its membership. Infrastructure master maintain the group membership and universal group. So when you create a global and universal group in any domain, that group and its membership is get cast in the infrastructure master role. So it means that if there is no infrastructure master role, if you, let's say in this case, I have a printer which is in a USA domain and my user is in India domain, when the user of India who is a member of a global group is having given a permission on this printer, this particular domain controller will go back and ask this domain controller of India that, do you know this user Ram who claimed to be the member of India domain? Okay, if you clearly say that, agar ye infrastructure master role is domain USA domain mein configured nahi hai, so jaise hi tum yahan pe koi user jo ki India domain ka hai, agar wo USA domain ke printer ko access karne ki koshish kar raha hai apne global group ke through, kyunki is global group ko tumne yahan pe permission de rakha hai, right? You have assigned the permission of the global group on this printer. So your local domain controller, which is a USA domain controller, want to know that whether this user is a valid user or not. So what is the way it has? It go back and ask techpledge.com, do you know any user, any domain called India? It say that, yes, I know India domain. Then it will contact the India domain controller. Then in a India domain controller will validate that, yes, this user Ram is exists. Then it inform back to the techpledge.com. Then the techpledge.com inform the USA domain that, yes, that user Ram is a valid user and it is exist in a India domain. Right? So it will take a long path for an authentication. But because of this infrastructure master role, so whenever the global group is created in any domain and whenever we make the membership, this infrastructure master role will get updated automatically. So the infrastructure master role, which is configured on a domain controller, will get updated the moment a global group or universal group is created anywhere in the forest. Okay? So what is the impact if there is no infrastructure master role, or the if this particular domain controller, if this particular domain USA, if the infrastructure master role domain controller is down, then whenever a user of another domain try to access the resource of a USA domain, then their authentication will take long time. Okay? So the infrastructure master role contains the group and the membership across the forest. Now, what is the role of a domain naming master? Domain naming master will verify, that the new domain which you are going to create in the forest, whether that name is unique or not. So the domain naming master is validate the uniqueness of the domain name which is created. So it means that if you try to, let's say for an example, if someone tried to create another domain called usa.techplace.com, and if this name is already exist in the forest, then your domain naming master will say that, boss, you cannot create this domain because this domain is already exist in the domain. So it will verify that, in the domain, the uniqueness of the domain name is always maintained. Okay. So when there is no domain naming master or domain naming master, let's say this particular server is down, then what would be the impact? You cannot create a new child domain. Create a new child domain. You also cannot remove the child domain. So to add the child domain, to remove the child domain, in both cases you require the domain naming master role. Okay. Now what is the infrastructure master, the schema master role? Schema master role say that whatever the schema need to be changes, that will be changes only on me. I will replicate these changes to all other domain in a forest. So what the schema master role says that schema can only change on the domain controller which is holding the schema operator master role. So what the schema operation master role says that?
So it only changes in itself and after that.
Yes, if any changes need to make in schema must change on domain controller which hold the schema. Okay, so if the schema operation master role is down, it does not make any impact in the domain working, but only when you try to run an application like Exchange which try to modify the schema, you unable to do so because it say that I cannot update the schema since the schema operation master role is not contactable. So if the schema operation is down, you cannot install the application like Exchange. Good. Now go back to your domain controller and let's see that where we can see the schema master role. Go back to the Active Directory user and computer. Right click that techplace.com and say operator master. Yes, so you will get a three operator master: RID, PDC and infrastructure. If you have another domain controller in the same domain, you have a change button. From there you can transfer the role. Good. Now open Active Directory domain and a trust.
Domain and trust.
Yeah. Active Directory domain and a trust. Right click that Active Directory domain and a trust and say operation master. So this will show you the domain naming operation master. Again, if you want to change, you can change it all. Good.